Hi, and welcome back to Science and Secrets. This is the fourth part of the science course. So, what I'd like to talk to you today is something a bit different from fascia. We've been talking about fascia up until now. Today I'd like to talk about something called ballistic stretching. Now, in Kalari, we use a lot of ballistic stretching in order to increase the range of movement in the joints, particularly in the hip joint through the swinging of the legs. But we're also doing some ballistic stretchings with the arms. So let's talk a little bit about what ballistic stretching is and how it differs from other types of stretching. Now, the most common form of stretching that we are familiar with from school, from yoga, from warming up for other sports and so on, is a more static stretching. Now, when you're doing static stretching, you're leaning forward as if you were to touch your toes, going as far as you can and holding it there. You would hold it for, according to evidence, about 30 seconds to get the required stretch. Now, there is some evidence that is saying if you hold that stretch for longer, for 2 minutes, then you're going to get a greater stretch. You're going to be able to make a bit more length in the tissues. Saying that, there is, despite the claims of many people, there is very little evidence to say we can lengthen fascia. Fascia itself has a lot of collagen in, and so it's very tough, very difficult. If you think of a chicken carcass, I hope I don't disgust you if you're vegetarian or vegan, but when you have a chicken carcass and you were to take the meat away from that, it comes away very easily. But when you try to pull that gristly part, it gets, it's very tough and sinewy, very resistant. And that's because there's a lot more collagen in that tissue. So within us, we have some of our fascia has a lot more collagen, some has more elastin and so on. But those parts which have more collagen are much more resistant to stretch. So if we come back to the evidence for stretching and looking at static stretching, yes, there is some research to say a 2 minute stretch will be better than a 30 second stretch, but it is very difficult for them to really say that they are able to lengthen the fascia itself. Now, in ballistic stretching, we're doing something slightly different. What we're doing is we're using the momentum of the movement that we are doing. We're using the gravity that is acting on the body during that movement, and we're using the limbs as a load that we are kind of throwing away from the midline or from the core. So for example, with these early alohas, so we're opening the arms, and when you're opening here, what you're doing is you're throwing the weight of the arm out to the side, gravity is acting on it, and the momentum is taking it so that it makes a stretch on to the joint capsule. Now, there is some evidence to say that ballistic stretching is not good. And according to the American, some American papers, which I'll put referenced in the bottom, but from the, I think it was the American Research Council, Sports Research Council, what they were saying is that doing ballistic stretching, like is done in martial arts and in ballet, can be dangerous. Now, what I would say is you need to do it very carefully. So when we're doing these kicks, when we're doing the leg exercises that you've come across in these first videos, and when you're doing anything where you're throwing the arms like this, or where you're bouncing on the joints, you need to be careful with that. So a ballistic stretch is basically using the momentum that we generate through movement to push the joint beyond its normal range. So you throw your leg up into that kick, and the weight of the leg pulls on the hip joint. It pulls on all of the muscles in the superficial back line. So the muscles that run up the back of your leg, your calf muscles, your hamstrings, run through your sacrotubular ligament, joining into the lumbar sacral fascia and running up the erector spinae muscles. So when you make that kick, when you throw that leg up, what you're doing is you're forcing that superficial back line to stretch, to lengthen, and it's lengthening beyond the range that it would normally do so. You're kind of tricking the stretch receptors. So you have stretch receptors in your muscles which tell your brain that you've got to the limit of the stretch. But when you throw the joint, so when you throw your leg up in the kick, or you throw the arms out in one of those preliminary exercises, or you bounce down towards the ground in one of those later lohas where we're doing the forward bends, in all of these, what you're doing is you're throwing the weight and kind of bouncing the joint. Now, as I said before, it's very important that you take these carefully. Despite the evidence from America, which I mentioned, there is evidence, research done in Britain, that shows that actually it can be okay and not damaging to the body. And in fact, doing these pendulum swinging exercises, ballistic stretches, can actually lead to a greater joint range being achieved than just doing your static stretches alone. So if you're looking to make gains, this is a very good way to do that in flexibility. I have students that have come to me who have been doing yoga for a long time, and when they do these exercises, they say they are definitely getting a considerable improvement in their range of motion. And I get students getting down towards into the splits after a couple of months. It's really about repetition, and it's about not pushing too hard. One thing that I try to teach all of my students is not to push during the practice. That's not to say that we don't want to search out our limits and reach those limits and go slightly beyond those limits every day. But at the same time, the way in which you do things, we want to keep the body released. We want to keep the movement as effortless as we can. As soon as you start to contract, to pump and to push, that's when you're going to strain something. I've been working for many years as an actor and dancer prior to being a martial artist. And as a martial artist, I've trained individually and as a group and taught now for about 14, 15 years. So I've seen a lot of people going through different ways of training. And what I can see as a pattern is that those who push are much more likely to get injured. Those who just work in that gradually extending range as you progressively train every day are able to make the gains in a way where they don't damage the body. And in a way which means they can keep training. They don't have to take a rest because they have a muscle strain. So to surmise, what we've got with ballistic stretching is a way of increasing your joint range by using momentum and the weight of the limb, by throwing the joint into a state where the stretch receptors do not pull back and allow the joint to go beyond its normal range. As long as that is done carefully and in conjunction with stabilizing exercises, for example, we are doing the leg swings for the hip and we are doing the elephant position to stabilize the hip. It's very important that you do those two things together. If you don't do the stability work, you're going to make your joints too open. And I come across this as a therapist, as a physio and Kalari therapist. I receive several clients, many clients really, who have issues with their joints, with the hip joint. They are yoga practitioners and they have pushed themselves into doing a lot of hip openers, which is a very common and popular part of the practice. But the end result of that is that they do often have some kind of inflammation in the hip and even some damage to the acetabulum, the hip joint itself. So it's very important that to balance your hip openers with hip strengthening exercises. And that's why in Kalari, that first leg kick, nerkal, straight leg kick, and the first posture, rajavalibhu, these work together as an excellent combination for lengthening and strengthening, stabilizing this hip area. Okay, great. We'll leave it there. I hope that's been useful to you. So we've talked about ballistic stretching now, and that ties into everything we've been talking about fascia. If there's anything that's unclear for you, please get in contact with me. As you can see, I'm here sat at the house where I've been making the live classes. This is probably where we're going to be for quarantine. And maybe you can see behind me in the background our Kalari. So I look forward to seeing you soon. Hope you can join some of the live classes. Until then, from me, Nalekanam. Wow.